हरि ओम। लेट अस स्टैंड द फर्स्ट 10 वर्सेस ऑफ चैप्टर 5। अर्जुन उवाच संन्यासं कर्मणां कृष्ण पुनर्योगं च शंससि यच्छ्रेयेतयोरेकम् तन्मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितम्। श्री भगवानुवाच संन्यासः कर्मयोगश्च निःश्रेयसकरावुभौ तयोस्तु कर्मसन्न्यासात् कर्मयोगो विशिष्यते। ज्ञेयः स नित्यसन्न्यासी यो न द्वेष्टि न कांक्षति। निर्द्वन्द्वो हि महाबाहो सुखं बन्धात् प्रमुच्यते। सांख्ययोगौ पृथक् बालाः प्रवदन्ति न पण्डिताः। एकमप्यास्थितः सम्यग् उभयोर्विन्धते फलम्। यत्साङ्ख्यै प्राप्यते स्थानं तद्योगैरपि गम्यते। एकं साङ्ख्यं च योगं च यः पश्यति स पश्यति। संन्यासस्तु महाबाहो दुःखमाप्तुमयो गतः। योगयुक्तो मुनिर्ब्रह्म न चिरेणाधिगच्छति। योगयुक्तो विशुद्धात्मा विजितात्मा जितेन्द्रियः। सर्वभूतात्मभूतात्मा कुर्वन्नपि न लिप्यते। नैव किञ्चित् करोमीति युक्तो मन्येत तत्त्ववेत्। पश्यन् शृण्वन् स्पृशन् जिघ्रन् अश्नन् गच्छन् स्वपन् श्वसन् प्रलपन् विसृजन् गृह्णन् उन्मिषन् निमिषन्नपि। इन्द्रियाणीन्द्रियार्थेषु वर्तन्त इति धारयन्। ब्रह्मण्याधाय कर्माणि सङ्गं त्यक्त्वा करोति यः। लिप्यते न स पापेन पद्मपत्रमिवाम्भसा।
ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति। Chapter 5, we continue with verse number 4. Verse number 4 reads, साङ्ख्ययोगौ पृथक् बालाः प्रवदन्ति न पण्डिताः। एकमप्यास्थितः सम्यक् उभयोर्विन्दते फलम्। साङ्ख्ययोगौ पृथक् बालाः प्रवदन्ति न पण्डिताः। एकमप्यास्थितः सम्यक् उभयोर्विन्दते फलम्। चिल्ड्रन् not the wise speak of Sankhya and Yoga as different. He who is duly established in one obtains the fruit of both. Children, not the wise speak of Sankhya and Yoga as different. He who is duly established in one obtains the fruit of both. For a casual reader, doesn't make any big difference. If you don't have the text next to you, it wouldn't make any difference at all. Even if you have the text, if you don't connect it to the previous verse, again it wouldn't make any difference. What is the difference? Sannyasa karma yogascha. He started with that two verses back. Now he has moved on to Sankhya yoga krutak balaha. From Sannyasa and karma yoga, he has shifted to Sankhya yoga and yoga. The words itself doesn't make any big. That's what I started. If you are not carefully reading, the words itself won't make any difference. And he is not shifting the words from one chapter to the other chapter. He is shifting the words in a matter of couple of verses. He is changing the words. There he says it is Sankhya. There he says it is Sannyasa. Here he says it is Sankhya. There he says Karma Yoga. Here he says it is Yoga. Now, as it is, the question is very difficult. As it is, what he is asking, he is talking in two colors at the same time. Not only he is doing that, he goes on changing the words also. So why can't you stick to the same word? Why do you have to keep changing the words? If you look at it carefully, Arjuna's question is not about Sankhya and Yoga. Arjuna's question is about Sannyasam Karmanam Krishna Punar Yogam Chasam Sashi. That is Arjuna's question in verse number 1, chapter 5. And we are currently studying the same chapter. First question. Sannyasam Karmanam Krishna. The question that he asked is sannyasa and karma. And then he started by saying sannyasa karma yogascha, verse number 2. Verse number 3, nyayasa nitya sannyasi. Verse number 4, which is what we started today. Sankhya yogau prithak balaha. Sankhya yogau. He is equating sannyasa to Sankhya and Karma Yoga to Yoga. He started connecting both. Balaha, speak. Children speak. Now we'll come to the children later. First we will do these two shift of the words. Sankhya means one who is predominantly treading the path of knowledge. Sankhya. And that a Sankhya is a sannyasi. Who is a karma yogi? A karma yogi is one who is a karma yogi? You should remember the karma yogi as in, this is where it gets that much difficult to remember, at least. And in all the classes, I keep giving those connections. Yoga. Samatvam yoga uchyate yoga karmasu kaushalam. Reference. Samatvam yoga uchyate yoga karmasu kaushalam. Which Upanishad this comes? In which Upanishad this comes? No, no, sir. Upanishad is not there. Chapter 2, Bhagavad Gita. This doesn't come in Upanishad. This comes in chapter 2, Bhagavad Gita. Verse number 48, verse number 50. He says, Samatvam yoga uchyate yoga karmasu kaushalam. So what is yoga? Samatva buddhi. Maintaining a balanced mind, equanimity and all is karma yoga. In action, all that is implied is maintaining an equanimity, balanced mind. Why? In action is karma yoga. Now what is sannyasa yoga? Advanced stage. In that advanced stage, you are no more worrying about equanimous mind and all, because you already bring in an equanimous mind. You already bring in a calm mind. Prashanta chittaya samanvitaya. He has already, the Upanishad says, he comes with the prashantam. He comes with the equanimous mind. The Upanishadic student, the advanced student, a sannyasi, comes with the equanimity already. By virtue of what he brought in the equanimity? He brought in the equanimity by virtue of the practices. What is the practices? Last class. A karma yogi manages likes and dislikes. I said karma yogi is one who is managing the likes and dislikes. Sannyasi is one who is transcending. Karma yogi is managing likes and dislikes. Managing the obstacles is karma yogi. Sannyasi is transcending. So before transcending, you need to first is manage and then transcend. So a karma yogi is one who is trying to manage the obstacles. So because of him having managed the obstacles, there's an equanimity. Because he has managed the obstacles. What is management of obstacles? Raga Dvesha. Since Raga Dvesha is under a fair, I wouldn't say fair, a very good amount of control, equanimity comes in. So what does the Karma Yogi do? Samatvam Yoga Uchyate Yoga Karmasu Kaushalam. Karma Yoga. Who is a sannyasi? Advanced stage of spiritual progress. I am Atma Brahma. That is advanced stage. Sannyasi is not happy by having a peace of mind. A karma yogi will be happy having a peace of mind. That's why people come and say, compared to previous sir, I have lot of peace and happiness. Sannyasi will not be happy with that. Sannyasi will not bother about that. Sannyasi will not be interested in that. For his is I am Atma Brahma. I am Atma Brahma is sannyasa. Are you able to follow? So now he brings in the two words. That's why I started by saying Sankhya Yoga and Sankhya and Yoga. The word Sankhya and Yoga refers to the definitions, refers to the entire discussion of chapter 2. The two words Sankhya Yoga Prithak Balaha. Arjuna, verse number 11, length 53, I told you very clearly. Sankhya Yoga, what is Sankhya Yoga? What is Karma Yoga? All this I told you very clearly in chapter 2. Balaha, you are a child. For you didn't learn. You are a child. You didn't learn anything from that. And you are asking the same question. Sankhya Yoga Prithak Balaha. Balaha means children. Who's a child? It will listen to everything and go back and does exactly what it wants to do. That is the child. What is the child? It will listen to everything. It will say yes, 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 yes. It will nod the head. It will write the notes. It will write the imposition that you ask the child to write. After finishing everything, it will go back and do exactly what it wants to do. That's why you say children, balaha, children. Child will behave like that. That's why you said The ignorant people in the world are referred as children. Referred as children. It speaks about the beauty and grandeur of the guru, the preceptor. When he is calling them children, it shows how deep is his understanding. How right and how deep is his understanding when he says, Balaha, children. And throughout the Gita, you find this expression, Balaha, Balaha, keeps repeating again and again and again, children. And what is the quality of the child? It will listen to everything. Even as it is listening, its focus is on, its focus will be on something else. It will be writing, it will be studying, it will be doing. As soon as the bell rings, நம்ம கூட இந்த கிளாஸ் ரூம்ல கூட அதே தான். 8:45 ஆச்சுனாலே பெல் ரிங் ஆகுமா, பெல் ரிங் ஆகுமா, அவ்வளவுதான். எக்ஸ்ட்ரா 5 minutes ஆச்சுன்னா சார் ஹாஸ் நோ டிசிப்ளின். Yeah, he is getting so involved. Aur yaar, there's a chance, just because he got a chance to speak and few people in the front, he doesn't stop talking. Why? That is Balaha. Are you able to follow? What is Balaha? The restlessness. What is the restlessness? As it is studying and listening and writing and doing everything, the focus is on? What is the focus? The focus is, when will the bell ring? And when the bell rings, the child will not ask, continue for 5 more minutes. See, that is the Upanishad. After the entire Upanishad is over, the bell has rung, the student is not getting up and going. The teacher is looking, now what? Teach the Upanishad, no? That is a sannyasi. Are you able to follow? That is a sannyasi. But we are all very disciplined, time-conscious people, no? We are all very strict in time and we keep everything to the time and timetable and all that. At 8:45 itself, the restlessness starts. So who's a child? Are you able to follow? Who's a child? A child is one, even when it is paying attention, even when it is present here, paying superficial attention here, the focus is on the bell ringing. And when the bell rings, you can see how joyfully they all come out. When they go in, how melancholy. When they go into the class, there is a melancholy. There is a pin drop silence. You know, in the morning hours, school is not vibrating, very quiet. As soon as the bell rings, you have the noise. Why? Because I did what you wanted me to do. From now on, leave me to do what? Are you able to follow? This is a child. I did what you want me to do. Now you leave me to do what I want to do. Pratak Balaha. Krishna says, these people are all children. What do they do? They have this distinction. What is the distinction? They say Sankhya and Yoga are different. Different means Pratak. Difference means what? What is superior to what? What will take you faster? What is best? Idallanda different. What is different means? Different means what is superior to what? If Karma Yoga is superior, if Jnana Yoga is superior, if Sannyasa Yoga is superior, I should be doing that which is superior. And you yourself say that is superior. And why are you asking me to do that which is inferior? Why are you underestimating my ability? Why are you underestimating my capacity? Why don't you think that I also belong to the same? Idallam than different. Are you able to follow? The children speak Sankhya Yoga and Sankhya and Yoga as different. You can see Sankhya and Yoga as different. One who is duly established in one, this is the beauty. One who is duly established in one obtains the fruit of both. Again, for a casual reader, it doesn't make any difference. One who is duly established in one obtains the benefit of both. Again, it is very confusing. Confusing if you are taking Bhagavad Gita seriously in studying. If you are not taking seriously in studying, there will not be any confusion. What is the confusion? How can you do one and get the benefit of both? How can you do one and get the benefit of both? It means there are no two. It means there are no two. For if you have to get the, if you do one and get the benefit of two, okay? Engineering college is different, medical college is different. Engineering study is different, medicine is different. Excel in one, you get the benefit of both. How is it possible? You excel in one, you become a master of that. That is possible. Are you able to follow? You excel in one, you can be a master of one, but you can't be a master of both. It means what? They are not two. They are one and the same. If they are one and the same, then why use two words? Yeah, that's the confusion. Don't worry, these confusions and all won't come. We will ask the first clarification, answer it. From that answer, we will ask the second question, and then we will ask the third question, and the fourth question, or more, you will get fed up, and we'll go to the next verse. So what is the first thing? If there are two, first thing is to say there are no two. For if both are different and opposite, they can't give the same result. If they are giving this, you master one and you get the same result, means they are not two. Are you okay till now? Then comes the question, then why use two words? Why can't you use the same word? Okay. Not only you use the same words, every few verses you keep changing the words also. Who is a child? You feel like asking Krishna, who is a child? Pravadanti. Speak. Pravadanti literally means the proper Tamil solnunna valarardun artham. You understand? No, blabbering. Is it blabber? Like a drunken man talking. What is a drunken man talking? No correlation between what he says before and what he says now. Arjuna accused Krishna of the same thing. And Krishna is proving by what? By using two different words. So if it is the same thing, I'm just trying to make it I don't want to get too technical and say everything at the same time. So every few minutes, I'm giving one step. Then comes, if both are one and the same, then why use two words? You have to use two words because it is one, but the stages are different. The path is one. The stages are different, therefore two words has to be used. Who understands this? One who is duly established in one obtains the fruit of both. What is the fruit of both? What is the fruit of Sankhya and Yoga, Karma and Sannyasa? The fruit of both, the destination of both is moksha, liberation, self-realization. It's not that Karma Yogi is having a different goal and Sannyasi is having a different goal. Goal is one and the same for both. Both are having the same goal. What is the same goal? The same goal of self-realization, moksha, liberation. But there are stages in that. There are stages. What is the stages? First is stage one, Karma Yoga. Stage two, Sannyasa. Stage one, Karma Yoga. Stage two, Sannyasa. In Karma Yoga, there are few things I said. Over the few sessions, I don't know, years or months or whatever we are studying this chapter 3 and 4 and 5, we gave so many different interpretations of the word Karma Yoga. So you have to connect all that. You have to write all that on one side, left hand side. And what is right hand side? The sannyasa, the advanced stage. It is not the different path. It is the advanced stage in the same path. So what is that advanced stage in the same path? Sannyasa yoga. I am Atma Brahma, number one. Number two, he is not asking about managing likes and dislikes. How do you know that you are asking questions about managing likes and dislikes? How do I deal with my children? Vedanta alla I have understood, sir. I am Atma Brahma. I am the self. Self-realization is the goal and all I have understood. But I don't know how to deal with my partner. I don't know how to deal with my children. I don't know how to deal with my mother-in-law. Na? Karma Yoga. Why? Because you are still asking questions about managing Raga Dvesha, managing likes and dislikes. So who is the now? So left hand side you have that Karma Yogi. On the right hand side you have Jnana Yogi. Sannyasi, not the awkward robe sannyasi. Doesn't mean awkward robe is wrong. Doesn't mean that either. He is in advanced stage. To indicate that he is in advanced stage and don't come and disturb me, he wears the awkward robe. That's why in the olden days, when a person wears an awkward robe, society will not go and disturb him. Society will go and give him whatever is needed for his sustenance. Society will feed him, and that's all. Society will not deal with him. Oh, he's a sannyasi, leave him alone, they will say. Because he wants to be left. He wants to be left alone. So in that sense, upper rope sannyasi. So first thing about sannyasi is maybe wearing an awkward rope, may not be wearing an awkward rope. Number one. Number two, who is a sannyasi? Sannyasi is one who comes with the prashanta chittaya samanvitaya. He brings in a calm mind. Number three, Karma Yogi brings in the preoccupied mind to the class. Sannyasi doesn't bring any preoccupied mind to the class. Are you able to follow? Karma Yogi brings in a preoccupied mind. What is a preoccupied mind? Before the class, so many things to do. After the class also, so many things to do. And most of it are unconnected to? Most of it are unconnected to what we discuss in this 1 hour? 1 hour and so. People follow? So, Karma Yogi brings in a preoccupied mind. Sannyasi have no other occupations. For a Karma Yogi, Sannyasi looks better. For he doesn't have the preoccupations of the Karma Yogi. That is why, frustrated by the preoccupations, the fellow wants to run away from all that and take up sannyasa. Are you able to follow? Because you look at the sannyasi, he need not worry. After the class is over, somebody will ring the bell and give him breakfast. Yeah. If breakfast doesn't come, he's happy. But we are not like that. Yeah. We have to do the batter last night itself and keep it. Yeah, we have to keep it safely. Adu pulika kudadu. Yeah, smell should not come. It has to come nicely. So many preoccupations we have. So the person who is frustrated with these preoccupations, tired of these preoccupations, because of the pain involved in these preoccupations, wants to take up sannyasa. What is known as rajasic sannyasa, and that person will say, go back to karma yoga. Because it is rajasic sannyasa, go back to karma yoga. Now what is the sannyasa advanced stage? By himself, there is no preoccupations. Even if there is a preoccupation, he knows it's the role that he has to play. He is not involved in that. Even if there is a preoccupation, even if there is an obligation, he understands it as the role that he has to play, and he plays the role to perfection. Deep down, unconnected to the role that he is playing. Idella yaru? Sannyasi. Ah, correct. Sannyasi. In and through the roles that he is playing, one part of him keeps asking this question, who am I? Who am I? Am I this role, or am I different from the role? Am I this role, or am I different from the role? Karma Yogi says, I am the role. There is no difference. Sir, linguistically, then the sentence, la, I am the role, I and role are different, la, only appears in the sentences. Grammatical difference. Tha. Existentially, both are one and the same. So don't bring in the grammatical difference and say, we and role is different. I am the role. Are you able to see the difference? I am the role. And then at the higher stage, they say, No, I am different. The role is different. But sir, this is hypocrisy. No, sir. But then this is hypocrisy. No, role. Play your role. No, immediately, sir. But then this is hypocrisy. No, sir. Whatever we do, we should put our heart and soul in it and be genuine in it. No? Go back to Karma Yoga. Go back to any questions that is asked about the right-hand side. The answer is go back to Karma Yoga, because you have not yet understood. You have not really understood. Go back to Karma Yoga. When it is said go back to Karma Yoga, what is implied here? Along with everyday Vedantic study, go back to Karma Yoga. That need not be repeated. When we say go back to Karma Yoga, don't forget that. Along with everyday study of Vedanta, Karma Yoga. Along with everyday study of Vedanta, Sannyasa Yoga. So the study of Vedanta is common to both. Why? Because for for the fourth stage, for Brahman, for God, this is the Pramana. What is the authority? MBBS also have to study medicine. Postgraduate also have to study medicine. Even you are doing a research, then also you study medicine, no? Because that is the Pramana. That is the field of act. That is the subject. So a Karma Yogi also does everyday study and reflection. A Sannyasi also does everyday study and reflection. So that is implied. So that which is common need not be told again and again. Are you able to follow? So that is why we will not talk about everyday study and reflection, for that is implied. So what is it? A Sannyasi understands, he is playing the, even if he is amongst the obligations, some doesn't have an obligation, some who has obligations understands it is the role that I have to play, but I am not this, but I am not this role. Then who am I? He does the Abhyasa. I am Atma Brahma. This Atman is Brahman. This Atman is Brahman. This Atman is Brahman. The practice. Who is a Karma Yogi? When you are faced with a joy and sorrow, if you are faced with joy and sorrow, if you are faced with joy, thank God. If you are faced with sorrow, you run to God, na Karma Yogi. Who is a Sannyasi? Joy and sorrow, witnessing it. It is the karmas that produced joy. It is the karmas that produce sorrow. And witnessing the joy and sorrow. And then you will feel like asking, I can read your mind voice also. Ittoda list mudinjida, like the next class will you come up with? Ittoda, is the list over or next class you will come up with something different? Adutha class but I really don't know. As far as today, these are the comparison. When there is a problem, the man looks for a solution. Sorrow, he looks for a solution. Joy, he is happy about it. Thank God, he says. Sorrow means running pillar to post, looking for a solution. Involved in that. Who is a Sannyasi? He will also be running pillar to post, but one part of him will be witnessing it. Are you able to follow? That's why it is very difficult to understand. The difference. He will also be running from pillar to post, but he will be witnessing. He will be practicing Sakshi Bhava. Again, who is a Karma Yogi? Manage the possessions. Manage the acquisition. Sannyasi. Carefully follow. Sannyasi's focus is in reducing it. Karma Yogi will not add up, but he will maintain it. Sannyasi will reduce. He will say, why have 10 kurtas? 4 is enough. And then he will say, why 4? 2 is enough. Why 2? Even 1 is enough. Are you able to see the difference? Karma Yogi manages the possessions. Ask him to reduce it, he'll feel restless. He may not add anything new. He may not be adding possessions, but he has to manage it. Sannyasi consciously Sannyasi consciously reduces it. Managing the possessions and obligations, sannyasi reduces the possessions and obligations. When the possessions and obligations are reduced, the responsibilities also reduce. The number of roles that you play also reduces. So you have that much time. You will have that much time to do what? I am Atma Brahma, to say that. Today, if you reduce the possessions and obligations and responsibilities, so much of time you have, and you will not know. And you will not know what to do with that time. Yeah. Apo then we have to worry about season 1, season 2, episode 1. Yeah. Season 1 liye episode 1, episode 2. Which episode you are watching? In the season la you are asking, sir. At least previously, ore episode number 350. Avladha. It is, you are very, now it is not like that. Which episode you are watching? In which season you are asking? Okay. Episode 45 in season 4. Why? So much of time not knowing. You have reduced your obligations. You have reduced your possessions. But you have so much of time not knowing. Not knowing what to do. Look at the entertainment column in the paper. How to fill the time. Sannyasi doesn't. He reduces the possessions. He reduces the obligations so that the responsibilities are less. Why the responsibilities are less? Because I am Atma Brahma has to be done. I am Atma Brahma has to be done more. Karma Yoga we all accept a lot because it doesn't take away anything from us. It talks about managing. That is why you find lot of people will be accepting Karma Yoga and all the other things that is said with Karma Yoga. When it comes to the advanced stage, people find it difficult to accept. From all this, what do we understand? It is not two different paths. It is two different stages in the same path. And how do you know where do you belong to? That's why I gave some indicators. Left hand side, right hand side. And the indicators, Allah, if you see, you will know. You will know where you belong to. The possessions reduces. When the possessions reduces, the obligations also reduces. When the obligations reduces, the responsibility also reduces. And then you'll be having that much of time to do what? After retirement only, I am leading my life. As though before retirement, you are leading somebody else's life. As though before retirement, you are leading somebody. Always you are leading your life only. What is it? The preoccupation is less. Clear? Preoccupation is less. Venkat's face in the class last year and Venkat's face now in the class. Same Venkat. But there is a huge difference. Clear? Previously, he will be like a sannyasi in the class. Preoccupation. Now, preoccupation, responsibility, manager, keys, so much of. Now, all that is over. even the small marginal difference that I bring here and there, he is like, the way he is, what is the difference? Venkat, correct? Huh? What is the difference? When it is that much more time to study, that much more time to reflect, that much more time to do this abhyasa. Very few are extraordinary. That very few can combine both, like a Janaka. Very few. That category is very few, and Krishna is not going to talk about that few. Upanishad talks about that few. Upanishad will talk about that few who can combine both. Active karma, extreme detachment. We are hoping one day in one janma we will come to that point, that extreme rare category. Very few can combine both. Who are that few? Like Janaka, like Rama, not Puranic characters, real. Who can combine both? What is it? They increase the activity, they increase the karma, they are so preoccupied from externally, they are so preoccupied, 24/7 occupied with everything externally, but internally untouched with anything, practicing I am Atma Brahma, there is that third category. Krishna is not talking anything about the third category. Throughout the Gita, he will not talk about the third category, because the third category is a very unique, different one where both have been combined. Are you able to follow? Now carefully follow. In the traditional way of teaching Vedanta, they wanted to combine both. Today, we have moved away from the traditional style of Vedanta. In the traditional way in which Vedanta was taught in the past, it was taught how to do Karma Yoga so dynamically from outside and yet be detached inside is always the vision of Vedanta. What happens today? What has happened today? We have segregated it into. We are mentally so divided into two that we are not able to. Even though we can theoretically understand how it is the best, when you start practicing it, you find that you are not able to combine the both. Are you able to follow? Very few belong to this category, and the training of Vedanta, the way in which Vedanta was taught in the past, is the vast majority of human beings must be of this category. At least if 50-60% of the human beings belong to this category, you will have an extraordinary, dynamic, sacrificial society. You will be having an extraordinary, dynamic, sacrificial society. Not only that, you will be having an extraordinary detached sacrificial society. Look at that. Not only sacrificing, there is a detachment to that sacrifice itself. What is detachment to the sacrifice? You will sacrifice and you will ensure that your sacrifice doesn't sit on the other as a burden. Today, you will sacrifice and you will want to make sure that the other person knows that you have sacrificed. And there is a pain in you when the other doesn't recognize your sacrifice. Are you able to follow? How much I have sacrificed, sir, but they don't. How much I have sacrificed, but they don't recognize. Vedanta is perfectly correct, sir. You do sacrifice, nobody recognizes. What do I do? Go back to Karma Yoga. Go back to Karma Yoga. Why? Because you sacrifice and you are detached to that sacrifice. Imagine, okay, why imagine a society? Imagine a family of 5 members. Even if 2 are like that in that family, even if 2 members in the family are like this, what will happen? Oh my God. It's something extraordinarily different. So the vision of Vedanta, the vision of Krishna is always not to see it as 2 extremities, is always to externally be a Karma Yogi and internally be a Sannyasi. That is the vision. Are you able to follow now? Externally be a Karma Yogi and internally be a Sannyasi. Today what has happened? People say all this is very nice to hear, very nice to do, but in practical life it will not work. It means what? That much of Sravana and Manana has to be done. Are you able to follow? It means that much of Sravana and Manana has to be done. To say all this is a Krishna is a wonderful teacher. To say all this, he just uses 2 different words in 2 verses. Where he said sannyasa karma yogascha, here he is saying sankhya yoga. Sankhya yoga. Why different words? Same words becomes a kind of lullaby. Same words you use, it becomes a kind of lullaby. You will fall off to sleep. Battlefield life, the Arjuna falls off to sleep, now what to do? So what he does, he brings in words. For at least the words will wake up. At least the words will wake. At least the words that he is using will wake Arjuna up. With this background, read the verse again. With this background, read the verse. What is it? Children speak of Sankhya and Yoga as different, not the wise. Rearrange the sentence, it becomes easy. Children speak of Sankhya and Yoga as different, not the wise. Na panditaha, wise. For all the words, today the meaning has become exactly ulta. That's why we are not able to use those words at all today. Because in our vocabulary, we have changed all the meanings. Today, panditaha means, today the word pandit means a person who has by-hearted and repeating it is we call as a pandit. No. So who is a pandit? Panditaha. He uses the word pandit. Who is a pandit? A wise one. Who is a wise one? Who has digested the knowledge. A wise is one who has digested the knowledge. Unwise is one who has memorized the knowledge. Unwise is one who has memorized. Panditaha, the wise one who has digested it. Digested the knowledge, understands what one who is established in one attains the benefit of both. A few verses in the Gita, in the 18 chapters, there are very many verses like this where you will have a problem. And one of the problem is this verse. One who is duly established in one obtains the benefit of both. even if you fully get established in karma yoga, you will get the benefit of what the sannyasi also gets. What is the benefit that sannyasi get? What is the benefit? Conviction in moksha. Conviction in moksha as the only goal of life. Karma yogi has many goals. Of the many goals, moksha last. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Descending order la varum. And the descending order la vara goal la moksha will be the last one. In a sannyasi, there is no ascending order, descending order. Only one goal. What is that goal? That goal of moksha. Are you able to follow? Sannyasi has only that goal. So, Arjuna, the vision of Vedanta, the vision of Krishna, the vision of Bhagavad Gita, the enlightened master is recognize who you are. Know who you are. That is the vision. That is the message. What is the message? The message is know who you are. Even when you are crying and suffering and suffocated by bondage, the wise man says, what bondage are you talking about? For there is no bondage. That is the vision. Are you able to follow? Now, we are not convinced enough about that. It's not that we don't understand. We are not convinced enough about that. Why are we not that convinced? Because so much of other preoccupations, so much of other things. Why so much of other preoccupations? So much of other preoccupation because that many vasanas you have. That many likes and dislikes you have. That is why that many preoccupations. So much of preoccupations because of what? Not because of the family, not because of the children, not because of the office occupation. You have that many desires. Because you have that many desires, you go on creating more and more occupations and obligations for your own self. Who's a sannyasi? Who has gotten rid of this raga dvesha a lot? That's why the first distinction between karma yogi and a sannyasi is managing likes and dislikes, transcending likes and dislikes. Of the very many goals, moksha is one. Of the very many goals, moksha is one. In the advanced stage, only moksha. Okay, yogi sannyasi. Idu rendu yogi sannyasi. Who is a jnani? Yogi and sannyasi having the goal of wanting to become a jnani. And who is a jnani? That is too difficult to digest. Sannyasi itself is difficult to digest. A jnani is impossible. Why? Because he says, the snake is biting me. The snake is chasing me. I am frightened by the snake. He says, where is the snake? How to deal with the fear of the snake? First he will ask, show me the snake, then I will teach you. Then you will show him. And what you show him, he says, it's a rope. Are you able to follow? You say, I'm frightened. Snake. He says, okay, where is the snake? Show me the snake. And you show him the snake. And he says, ஞானி. He says, snake geta, you are showing the clear. When I'm asking you to show the snake, you are showing me the rope. He goes out of focus. Jnani goes out of comprehension completely. Jnani goes out of comprehension completely. But the goal of Vedanta is what? Yogi, sannyasi, and jnani. Yogi, sannyasi, jnani. Are you able to follow? We are not discussing jnani as yet. We are still discussing yoga and sannyasa. Arjuna's question is what? Of the two, which is? Of the two, which is better? He is not asking. You told me very clearly, of the two, sannyasa is better. And why are you asking me to? Why are you asking me to do the inferior? You are telling me that is better. Okay, what should I do now? Do the inferior. Are you able to follow? Children, not the wise speak of Sankhya and Yoga as different. He who is established in one obtains the fruit of both. Meaning, both have only one fruit. Karma Yoga is not going to have a different fruit. Bhakti Yoga is not going to have a different fruit. Jnana Yoga is not going to have a different fruit. Fruit is only one. What is the fruit? The fruit is moksha. Children, balaha. Balaha means, we have seen that already. Who is a child? As paying attention here, waiting to get back to, yeah, we used to do that, no? Hey, innings appadiye stop pannunga, after the class is over, we will come back and continue the innings. Yeah, we will start playing, you know, we used to play, and then suddenly halfway through some class, something will happen, so what we will do? Abdabdiye. We used to play chess a lot. We used to play chess a lot. Me and my friend who used to play chess in the classroom while class is happening. Now he has become the principal in the same school. So I asked him, you know, last year also when he visited me, I asked him, namba panna mari pasanga play chess when we'll keep it as it is, as because of all the five teachers, four teachers are very agreeable to us. One teacher only will not agree to what we do. He will come and disturb the whole thing. So when he comes, he will say, before we disturb the coins, we remember the position. So as soon as he goes, we put all that in the same position and continue. And as he is teaching, we will be looking at him. And he will ask us questions and we will answer those questions also. Number class punishment, we are facing the you ask exact, he asks the question, we will answer those questions also. After the class is over, he will come, you know, friendly. One tap he will give and say, Buddhi la ingyo irukudhu, he will say. He will answer the question. After answering the question, as he is leaving the classroom, he will give one tap. And you see, Buddhi la ingyo mean attention is elsewhere. He wanted to say, yes, when are you going to leave so that we can get back to what we wanted to do? Balaha, children. He understands, the teacher understands. One day these children will mature. Till that time, they have to be. Are you able to follow? One day they will mature and that fellow will not leave. One day they will mature And till that maturity happens, he has to keep teaching. He has to keep repeating the, he has to keep teaching the same thing. He has to keep repeating the same thing. Balaha. This is verse number 4. We move on to verse number 5. Because 4, 5 and 6 is having a similar thought. Having a similar thought. Verse number 5. We move on to verse number 5. Verse number 5 reads, Yat Sankhyai Prapyate Sthanam Tat Yogai Rabi Gamyate Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha Yah Pashyati Sa Pashyati. Beautiful. Yat Sankhyai Prapyate Sthanam Tat Yogai Rabi Gamyate Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha Yah Pashyati Sa Pashyati. That state which is reached by the Sankhyas is reached by the yogis also. He who sees Sankhya and Yoga as one, he sees. Same thought. Are you able to follow now? It's the same thought. That state which is reached by the Sankhyas, Arjuna, yogi also reaches. So, what does it mean? Both are the same path. Both are in the same path. What are you worried? That as though you will get distracted by doing karma yoga and only sannyasi will get moksha and you will get distracted. What makes you to think that you will end up in a different goal? Are you able to follow Arjuna's problem? Arjuna's thinking, by practicing karma yoga, I will end up in a different destination. Whereas those who are practicing Sankhya yoga, sannyasis alone will go to moksha. That is Arjuna's doubt, fear, misunderstanding, for which Krishna makes a direct statement, direct answer. What is it? Yat sankhyai prapyate sthanam tat yogai api gamyate. Api gamyate. Api gamyate means they also get. They also reach. What do they reach? The same goal. Therefore, do not worry, Arjuna. Be sincere and dedicated here. Be sincere and dedicated here. It will take you. Why are you comparing yourself with? Why are you unnecessarily comparing it with somebody? Somebody else. Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha Yah Pashyati Sa Pashyati. Another very famous off-quoted phrase from the Bhagavad Gita. Yah Pashyati Sa Pashyati. Whoever sees it. Yeah. Whoever sees it. What do they see? Ekam. Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha. They see both as one. One means earlier stage, later stage. Path is the same road. It's not two different roads leading to two different destinations. One road, one destination. One road, one destination stages. One road, one destination stages. What is important is, first thing is to come on to the road. What is important? Take a U-turn. Now you are in opposite road. Take a U-turn and come to this road. Having come to this road, be sincere and dedicated to that. For you will reach the same goal. Later on, Arjuna will ask how much time it will take. Okay, I have understood that. I will also reach the same goal, but eppo, when I will reach, adhum solitelna, it becomes easy. For which Krishna says, very soon you will. Or, before writing the exams, the child comes and asks, how many marks I will get? How much marks will I get? What answer you will give? What answer you will give? Bring your answer paper. Give me your answer paper. Then I will tell you how much marks you will get. Even before writing the answer, if you come and ask how much mark you will get, the answer is, what is the honest answer? I don't know. Mother will say 100 marks you will get. Yeah, mother will say 100 marks you will get. Because according to the mother, their children are. Yeah, world has seen millions and millions of mothers, but still the individual mother thinks that she is the best mother, better than her own mother. Yeah, she thinks what to do. The world has seen millions and millions and millions of lovers, and yet the two who falls in love think they are the best, and they know exactly what they are doing, and nobody else. Children, idella balaha. Children will do all that. Ya pashyati sa pashyati. Whoever sees it. What do they see? Sankhyam and yogam as one. One means there is no inferiority or superiority between the two. Second is, both are not going to lead you to different goals. In that sense, both are one and the same. Technically speaking, karma yogis will use the karmendriyas a lot. Sankhya yogins, sannyasis, will use jnanendriyas. That is the technical difference. I'll explain that also. Karma yogis will be using the karmendriyas a lot. Which indriya you predominantly use, depending on that, you know which yoga you belong to. Karmendriya or Jnanendriya. The active people are the yogis who use Karmendriyas a lot. What is Karmendriyas means? They have to be in action. They are predominantly focused on action. And inaction is restless. No action makes them restless. No action makes them feel guilty. No action makes them feel they are doing something wrong. That is why the karma yogi will go on asking, sannyas ella is fine, sir. Sannyas and all is fine. But we have to do action, no. We have to do our duties, no. We have to do our obligations, no. We have to do our obligations to me, to the family, to the society, to the country, to everything. All that is there, no. How can we become a sannyasi? This is a karma yogi. Predominantly using the organs of action. Who is a sannyasi? Contemplator. What are they do? They use the organs of perception more for their evolution. What is using the organs of perception for evolution? Kena Upanishad. Kena Shitam Patati Preshitam Manaha Kena Prana Pratama Praiti Yuktaha Kena Shitam Vachamimam Vadanti Chakshushrotram Kaudevo Yunakti. What is it that makes the eyes to see? What is it that makes the ears to hear? Srotrasya Shrotram Manaso Mano, the answer. Are you able to follow? In Keno Upanishad, we see the distinction very clearly. when Nachiketas goes to Yama, Yama teases him, you have left your duties and you have come here. When Krishna plays the flute, all the gopis come and Krishna teases the gopis, saying, you have left your, I am playing flute for my time pass, why are you coming? I am playing flute for my time pass. I am sitting and எனக்கு வேலை இல்லைன்னு 7:45 ஐ ஓபன் த ஜூம் அண்ட் சிட்னா ஒயர் யூ கம்மிங். கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ், டோன்ட் யூ ஹாவ் யுவர் டியூட்டிஸ், டோன்ட் யூ ஹாவ் யுவர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டிஸ், ஹவு கேன் யூ லீவ் ஆல் தட் அண்ட் கம் ஹியர். கரெக்ட் சார், டுடே ஓன்லி யூ ஸ்போக் சம்திங் வெரி வெரி சென்சிபிள், க்ளோஸ் இட் அண்ட் கோ பேக் அண்ட் டூ வாட் வி. This is yogi predominantly using the yoga of action. They will be constantly planning for action. Adhan karma yoga. Yeah. Adhan karma yoga. R.D. Prasad at 70 is planning something and started new venture. Yeah. Adhan karma yoga. Always planning for action. எல்லாம் விட்டாச்சு, ரிட்டையர் ஆயாச்சு, கம்முன்னு உட்காரலாம்ல. Have to, are able to follow Prasad. Always planning for action. Always planning for something, something, something. It's not inferior, it's not wrong. That person belongs to Karma Yogi. Who is a Jnana Yogi? Who is a Sannyasi? He is not planning for action. Nor he is an escapist from action. He is not an escapist from action. He doesn't have that many vasanas, so he need not plan for action at all. Are you able to see the difference? Venkatachalam. He doesn't have that many desires, therefore he need not plan for action. Karma Yogi has to plan, will be planning for action. Why? Because he has that many. He has that many desires. சாங்க்யம் யோகம் ச யஃ பஷ்யதி ச பஷ்யதி. This man doesn't. So what he uses? He uses Jnanendriyas, the organs of perception for evolution. Yogis, yogi means karma yogi, uses karmendriyas for evolution. Jnana yogi uses Jnanendriyas for, அதுலயே அந்த words வந்தது, karma yogi na karmendriya. You need not bother at all. Sannyasi, Sankhya Yoga means using Jnanendriyas. What is Jnanendriyas? The organs of perception. He says, the eyes registering a perception is an action. The ears hearing the sound is an action. The eye is registering a perception. You get carried away by what you perceive. You get carried away by what you perceive. Sannyasi, Sankhya Yogin says, what is it that is making me to perceive? Is eyes the reason for perception? Is the gross organ? No. Is the indriyas? No. Is mind? No. Is buddhi? No. Then what is it? The enlivening factor, Brahman, Atman. Are you able to follow how? Are you able to follow how it works? Is eyes seeing? He will turn back and ask, eyes means you mean the fleshy eyes? No, no, no. The indriya. What is the indriya? We have studied that in Atmabodha very clearly. The sense center. Indriya. Is indriya that sees? No, no, no. It is the mind that has to back the indriya. Okay, so abdina mind sees, huh? No, 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 no. It's not the mind that, it's not the mind that sees, the intellect. Oh, it is the intellect, huh? Ellathukku anga main control othar vechirukkarare. The main controller. Who is the main controller? Who is the main controller? The enlivening factor, Brahman. the Atman. He registers a sight and he remembers Brahman. He hears a sound and registers Brahman. Sannyasi. Karma Yogi register a sound. The sound nalla irukudhu, the sound nalla illa. This sound is pleasant, this sound is unpleasant. This is good, this is bad. This is agreeable, this is disagreeable. All these distinctions, meaning responses have come in. So what is the difference now? Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati tapashyati. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati tapashyati. What does ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha means? What does that mean? Goal is the same, stages are different, and no need to feel inferior about what stage you are in. As long as you are sincere and dedicated to that stage where you are, it will take you to the ultimate goal. That's what in Vedanta treatise, lesson 2, he says, where you are is best suited for your evolution. Vedanta treatise, chapter 2, he says, where you are is best suited for your evolution. You need not make an effort to change the environment. If that is needed, it will change by itself. Where you are is best suited for your evolution. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati tapashyati. A karma yogi can get detached temporarily to study knowledge. Sannyasi can be permanently detached from everything so that he can be urga in it. Yeah, he wants to turn into a pickle. Yeah. So sannyasi na Vedanta pickle nu vechukom. Yeah, Vedanta pickle than sannyasi. Because he is soaked in it. Yeah. Like the pickle Rajini sends me, you know, like that. Yeah, like that kind of a pickle. They is so soaked in it. The thought of it is salivating for me. Yeah? Huh? The very mention of it is salivating. He is so grounded in that. That is sannyasi. Ya pashyati, sa pashyati. It is not wrong to be a child. If you are stuck in childhood, it is a disease. Ya pashyati sa pashyati. What is ya pashyati sa pashyati means? It is not wrong to be a child, for all of us are children at some stage. So it is not wrong to be a child. It is not sin to be a child. It is not inferior to be a child. If you are stuck there, it is a disease. If you are stuck in it, it's a disease. If you are stuck in it, it's a disease. Yogi, sannyasi, jnani says, at any point of time, wheresoever you are, that is the path for your, that is the stage for your evolution. And you need to use that for your growth. So technically, yogis means karma yogi uses karmendriyas. Karmendriyas means constantly planning for action. Planning for action, through that action, the benefit, and then get rid of the benefit, and then remember God as karma paladata, and then God. That is karma yogi. A sannyasi uses organs of perception, jnanendriyas. What is organs of perception means? He registers a sight, he remembers Brahman. He hears a sound, he registers Brahman. यः पश्यति स पश्यति यः पश्यति स पश्यति विद दिस वी कंक्लूड वर्स नंबर 5. Yes. Venkatachalam, I answered, no?
I have a just question. I think yes. After I wrote, you immediately answered that question very well, as yes. if you intuitively understood what I'm going to ask.
Yeah.
The second question I have is it not the dharmic duty of one to exhaust, to be a karma yogi and do good in the larger interest of the society, for someone like Rama or Janaka or even Shankaracharya or Vivekananda, and only move to be a sannyasin at a stage when you believe that you have exhausted and someone else can carry the duty, the dharmic duty?
The question is it not the dharmic duty to do karma yoga? First, exhaust the obligations and then become a sannyasi. Correct?
Yes.
Now, for a karma yogi, the twin purposes of karma yoga, lokakshema and chitta shuddhi. Karma yoga has two purposes. Karma yoga has two purposes. The twin purposes of karma yoga is lokakshema and chitta shuddhi. Lokakshema is welfare of the loka, the world. Chitta shuddhi is purification, inner purification. Now, karma yogi has to do both. In fact, karma yogi need not do both. The benefit of karma yoga is these two. You practice karma yoga, the twin benefits of karma yoga. What are the twin benefits? One side, it will be loka sangraha, welfare of the community, the society, the world at large. Simultaneously also what will happening? Simultaneously also what will happen? Your
chitta
shuddhi means self-purification,
inner
purification. So, karma yoga always has
twin benefits.
Twin benefits. The twin benefits of karma yoga is loka kshema. Because karma yogi is practicing unselfishness. When he is practicing unselfishness, it is benefit to the loka.
Society.
So, loka kshema. Now, generally what happens is, the mistake is, people take only one and miss the other. People say, I work for the welfare of the society. Vedanta comes and says, who are you to work for the welfare? He who made it knew. Therefore, you don't have to have the arrogation. Abdina, then will I work for my own inner purification? Yes, work for your inner purification. What is the inner? Then how do I achieve inner purification? Work for the welfare of the society. Are you able to follow? Beautifully.
Yes.
Are you able to follow? So, karma yoga has these twin benefits inherent. What are the twin benefits inherent? One is lokakshema. Another is chitta shuddhi.
Inner purification.
Inner purification. Now, as a karma yogi, you are not interested either in, carefully follow, dhan karma yogi. As a karma yogi, you are neither interested in loka sangraha or chitta shuddhi. What is your goal?
Moksha.
Exactly correct. Venkatachalam, you are exempted from the classes. You have learned. Yeah. What is the goal of karma yogi? Moksha is the goal for which he pursues the path of karma yoga, and that karma yoga produces these two benefits.
Oh, these two benefits.
What are the two benefits?
Loka
shuddhi and loka kshema.
Loka kshema.
Yeah, loka kshema. Lokas means all the lokas. Loka shema. Loka means 14 lokas, they said, no? You work for the benefit, you, the circle of identification. Loka kshema means the circle of identification. You go to the extent of saying even people in Naraka also, even people there. Why? No, that's where you find all the mantras that we use in the rituals are all for loka kshema only.
Okay.
But then the same thing you can use for a selfish benefit also.
That's right.
The same thing can be used for a selfish benefit also. But then it is like having an extraordinary tool and using it for
wrong purpose.
For a very limited purpose.
Limited purpose.
Very limited purpose. Swamiji's example is knowing the Prime Minister very well, and he said, whatever you want, you come to me, he said, and you go to him asking for a sleeper class ticket confirmation.
Yeah.
Yeah, you call the Prime Minister and say, what? I have my RAC, my ticket is in RAC. Can you upgrade it to sleeper class? Knowing the Prime Minister, why will you want to? Are you able to follow?
Yes.
So, Karma Yogi goal is moksha. Karma Yogi's goal is moksha, and he does karma. That karma has twin benefits. What are the twin benefits? Loka kshema and chitta shuddhi.
Inner purification.
Inner purification. So, loka kshema and inner purification becomes more of an
attitude.
A preliminary stage, a preliminary step
towards
the goal.
Moksha.
Are you okay?
Towards moksha. Yes. Fine.
Therefore, it is not said it is the duty. The duty is, moksha is the duty. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Moksha is the duty.
Yeah.
In the four purusharthas, Vedas have declared it very clearly. Dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Moksha is the duty. Moksha is the destination. There are no two mokshas for anybody. There are no two goals for anybody. Goal is common for everybody. Very few accepts it. Most say, I don't accept it. But nevertheless, goal remains the
same.
So, a Karma Yogi says, for moksha, what I should do? A set of actions is given, prescribed. When he does those set of prescribed actions, loka kshema becomes the byproduct.
But there can be many loka kshema benefits.
Yes.
There may be something of a high priority.
Yes.
But for a karma yogi, that means he has a choice to do what?
Yes.
Say, for example, he can be doing some activities that certainly produce a benefit.
Correct.
But there can be others that can produce bigger, more impactful benefit to the society.
Exactly correct.
So that priority is not compelling on the person who is doing the activity.
Exactly correct. That depends upon how much of individual likes and dislikes they have. A person who is able to, like a scientist, is doing karma yoga, loka kshema.
Yeah.
A scientist, okay. Let us say there are a group of people who are treating the COVID-19 patient, knowing fully well they will get it. Loka kshema. It means they have risen above that immediate circle. It means they have risen above that immediate circle. See, here, I am so worried about my immediate circle. What is my immediate circle I am worried about? I am worried about my child, my mother, my father, and I tell them, don't go out, don't do this, don't do that. But here there are a set of people risking their immediate, risking their life. And what are they doing? That is called loka kshema, karma yoga. It means they are willing to let go of something
bigger,
something at a level, because they don't have that strong desire at that level.
Okay.
It means they don't have that strong desire at that level. For a person who is so caught up in the level of the family and all that, to tell him, imagine a doctor caught up at the level of the family. He will say, every time the duty comes, he will say, I have a toothache, I have a stomachache, I have this, I have that. Why? Because I go, I will contract the disease. Now, who will take care of? Who will take care of my family? Who will take care of my family? That person says, no, my duty is to be there and serve. In that service, there is a sacrifice, which that person doesn't feel it as a sacrifice at all. Why? Because he has no desire. Yes. But the person at the lower level only sees it as a sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
Are you able to follow? Only a person at a lower level sees it as a sacrifice, because he says, when I am not able to leave it and go, how is he able to? When I am so caught up in my family circle and can't think anything beyond that, even though the doctor also has a family, how is he able to think?
Think of a larger cause. A larger cause.
Yeah.
I mean, this is also the crux of Bhagavad Gita.
Yes.
Krishna rightly advising Arjuna not to run away from the pressing immediate duty. That's all everything is about.
Correct. You shouldn't run away from where you are. That's a pressing duty. You have to be there where you are.
Where you are.
Aparama vangu India. When things are all normal, you can you can come back. Where you are now is where you have to be and do karma yoga.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Is it okay?
Yeah, thank you.
With this, we conclude for today. Verse number 6, next class, we continue.